It should be noted that most of the relations that are in 3NF are also in BCNF. Infrequently, 3NF relation is not in BCNF. This happens because of the following points. There are certain relations in 3NF which are not in BCNF. It is because of the three important points. The candidate keys in the relation are composite keys. There is more than one candidate key in a relation which creates a problem in BCNF. And the keys are not disjoint. That is, some attributes in the keys are common. The BCNF differs from 3NF only when there are more than one candidate keys and the keys are composite and overlapping also. So this is the major difference actually between BCNF and 3NF. Every BCNF normal form tables are in 3NF, but the only difference is that all the determinants table or determinant column in BCNF database are always the candidate key, but it may or may not be in 3NF. So whatever the determinants are there in 3NF tables, they may or may not be the candidate keys of the table. But here in BCNF, compulsorily all the determinant columns should be candidate key. So it is taken from a reference book, this difference, BCNF and 3NF. You have to write 2 points in BCNF and 3 points in 3NF. For every functional dependency, that is x is to y, it means x determines y, in a set of functional dependencies or a relation R, where these two conditions satisfied. Y is a subset of x. It means the values of y depends on the values of x. X is the determinant column, or you can say the primary key or super key of that, where x is a super key of relation R. So these 2 points you need to write into BCNF. So here every determinant should be a candidate key, or it is a super key, right? Then only we can say that particular relation is in BCNF. But what happens in 3NF? For functional dependencies such as x determine y in a set of functional dependencies over the relation R, either of the conditions should be true. There are three conditions. Now, y is a subset of x. So the first line is same in both BCNF and 3NF. Second, now x is a super key of R. This is also same. So both the lines, first and two lines, are same. Now only the last line is different. That is very important. There exists a column Y, which is a subset of another column, that is K, for some key K of R. It means that Y is a subset of more than one keys into the same relation. Overlapping functional dependencies happens in 3NF, but that does not happen in BCNF. To understand this, I have given one example here. A table having three columns, that is account, client and office. Account, client and office. Here, client and office determines the information of client, office and account. Whereas only account can determine the office. Account determines office. So these are the functional dependencies in this table. 3NF has some redundancy, but BCNF does not have any redundancy. So we move from 3NF to BCNF only to remove the redundancy that exists between 3NF. In the above table, we can say that the table is in 3NF, but still there is some redundancy in the last column. You can see office information is repeated. Unfortunately, BCNF is not dependency preserving, but 3NF always satisfies the dependency preserving property. So to avoid this repetition, what we do is we divide this 3NF table into BCNF. So we make this table into two half. One is account office and another is account client. So here the account information is coming only once. In previous example, the account information was repeated. Here it is coming only once. So account number is the primary key of or candidate key of this relation. Then the another table consists of account and client information, where you can see there are four attributes here, and which gives the information of account and client. So you can check the previous table and these two tables. Now there is no repetition of office information, or there is no repetition of account information. They are coming only once. So repetition or redundancy has been removed, which was there in 3NF table. We can consider these two tables are in BCNF, because every determinant into this particular tables are candidate keys. How it is? Account determines office, then account determines client. So here we can say that every determinant column is a candidate key, and that's why these two tables are in BCNF now. Yes, Nikita, have understood? You asked me this question, no? BCNF and 3NF. So if it is asked in your examination, you can write these 3 points, 2 points about BCNF, 3 points about 3NF, and give a small example, take a table which is in 3NF but not in BCNF, and try to convert that table from 3NF to BCNF like this. This example is given in the PDF. You can give the example as it is by changing the names or